spacecraft were turned on. These recorders record both voice and data. Spacecraft now to full internal cooling. The cooling load has been shared with a ground cooling. T-minus 90 seconds and counting. T-minus 90 seconds and counting. At T-minus 1 minute 15 seconds, the spacecraft batteries will be turned on for launch. These batteries will give an additional power source to the spacecraft, as well as be acting as a backup for the fuel cells. The third stage liquid hydrogen tanks now pressurized. All third stage tanks pressurized. Second stage tanks also pressurized. T-minus 1 minute. T-minus 1 minute and counting. Now moving into the final minute of the count. We'll be standing by for the switch over to internal power. Switch over taking place at this time, going on internal power. T-minus 45 seconds and counting. Guidance aligned, just announced by John Young. That will be the last action taken by the crew aboard the spacecraft. T-minus 35 and counting. Countdown continuing to go well, T-minus 30. T-minus 25, 24, 23, 22, 21, 20, 19, 18, 17, guidance release, 15, 14, 13, 12, 11, 10, 9. We have ignition sequence start. The engine's now building up to 7.7 million pounds of thrust. We have a launch commit and we have a liftoff. The speed arm moving back. The Saturn V lifting off the tower, off the pad, building up thrust. We clear the tower.
Houston is now controlling. Crawley has had thrust now 5.
Roger.
Mission roll program started. Good.
Roger.
16 now, moving to a proper flight path attitude. Mark 27 seconds.
Now capable of water landing. Mark 1 minute 12 seconds coming up on period of maximum aerodynamic pressure on the vehicle. One minute 22 seconds. 6 nautical miles in altitude. Looking good.
And maximum dynamic pressure area is the
Mark 1 minute 30
one
seconds.
They watch for.
Eight
That's when the vehicle
altitude.
Takes the most severe buffeting of the entire liftoff. And it's critical, of course.
Mark, 1 minute 41 seconds.
It's interesting how that pass through max fuel still above the altitude where it falls.
And everything looks good.
You can see that they're
16 now, 12.5 nautical miles in altitude. Young Duke Mattingly moving out to the outer traces of the Earth's atmosphere. Stand by.
You see contrail rather likely, of course, it's a vapor trail.
Mark, 2 minutes 3 seconds. The status check in mission control by Flight Director Gene Kranz. A go, no go for staging.
We'll be able to see this, I think, with this beautiful shot, this new camera.
Coming up on center engine shutdown.
We'll be able to see the first stage shutdown and then separate.
Your inboard, your go for staging.
Center engine shutdown on time.
They've doubled the number of retro rockets for the stage.
28 seconds, 26 nautical miles down, 32 nautical miles downrange.
One on 15. It separated already, but not
35 seconds.
To make everybody heavy. So they doubled the
number. 2 minutes 40 seconds coming up on stage.
Break them apart. There it goes.
Oh, spectacular.
Staging. After ignition on the S2.
Roger.
You even saw the bells of the
2 minutes 53
It's amazing,
seconds.
Isn't it? The camera
on
really
the staging, a young Duke Mattingly now riding on 5 good second stage engines.
Going all 5 on the S2.
Ah, that's great.
3 minutes 2 seconds, the giant first stage falling away now. Its day's work completed.
That's one of the
Apollo 16 now 46 nautical miles
altitude,
80 nautical miles downrange.
Second stage.
It really is. Think of the old days, we had them all running once. Now we've got so many engines, you have to have this staging. And if those 5 engines don't start, it's a real short flight.
Roger.
Roger, and we confirm your skirt's up. You're mode 2 now.
Roger, mode 2.
3 minutes, 28 seconds. The launch escape tower is ejected on time. It's surveillance roll no longer required.
They're referring to the abort system, aren't
yes,
they?
Yes, that's a lesser stringent mode. That's where you start dropping some of the criteria.
Mark, 3 minutes, 45 seconds. Apollo 16, now 16 nautical miles altitude, 135
nautical miles downrange. Apollo
16,
now 33
feet shorter and 9,000 pounds lighter. Unencumbered now for its mission in space.
16, Houston, 4 minutes, everything.
I guess you're about the only person around that doesn't have TV coverage of the scene.
That's all right, I don't mind a bit.
They've got the flag up now, and you can see the stars and stripes on the limit.
Are you getting a TV picture now, Houston?
Neil, yes, we are getting a TV picture. You're in our field with you now.
That's one small step for man. One giant leap for mankind.